गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। Yesterday we were on question number 7, so we'll start with the same. So just wait for a minute. After a minute, we'll begin with the class. So without wasting any time, let us start as we have planned to complete the chapter today. So let us see, will it get complete or not? So we are left with 5 questions, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 6 questions, I guess. 6 questions are left. So let us start. Now question number 7, if diagonals of cyclic quadrilateral are diameters of the circle, so these are the diagonals and these are the diameters of the circle also. Now ABCD is cyclic quadrilateral, this is given, and diagonals and diameters are same in this case. In ABCD, we have to prove that it is a rectangle. Proof: AC and DB are diameters AC and DB are diameters again what I am saying AC and DB are diameters, so AO and OC and DO and OB are equal. AO is equal to OC and DO is equal to OB. Why? Because radii on the same circle. Reason for both will be radii of same circle. Yes, because DO, OB, AO, OC all are distance from center to the circle. So all are radii. Fine. So that's why radius of the same circle will be equal. So after this, we can say that since if we will see it from diagonals point of view, see this AC and DB are diagonals also, and diagonals are bisecting each other because AO, OC, DO, OB are equal. So we can say that since diagonals bisect each other, therefore ABCD is a, this property we have read in quadrilateral chapter, chapter number 8. If diagonals are bisecting each other, it means that quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Now we have proved this quadrilateral a parallelogram. Now after proving it a parallelogram, we can prove further that it is a rectangle also. Okay, then how we can prove that? See, if in a parallelogram, if you are able to prove any angle 90 degree, then it will be called as, cited as rectangle. So look here, angles in semicircle is 90 degree. This we all know. Since angles in semicircle is 90 degree. Angles I have written, so let us write here R 90 degree each. Fine. Now look here. This is semicircle. Yes. An angle in this semicircle is this angle A. So angle A is 90. Fine. Similarly, you can say that BCD all are 90. So this is proved. You can say that ABCD is a parallelogram whose diagonals are equal. Diagonals are equal or not? Because AC and DB are the diameters. AC and DB are diameters, and diameters are equal. So whose diagonals are equal, and one angle and one angle this way one angle is equal to 90 degree therefore ABCD is a rectangle hence proved Done. Now moving on to the next question. If you have any doubt in this, you can ask. This is just a small proving where you need to write this that the diagonals are bisecting each other. Therefore, it is a parallelogram. Then angle in semicircle are 90. Therefore, angle A is 90. If angle A is 90, then we can say that ABCD is a parallelogram whose diagonals are equal because diagonals and diameters are same. And one angle is 90. So ABCD is a rectangle. You can write even a reason here that AC and DB are equal. Diameters. That's why we have written that diagonals are equal. From diameters point of view, they are equal. Moving on to the next. Question number 8. And be a little fast today in writing. Okay, because we have to complete this today. Moving on to the question number 8. If the non-parallel sides of a trapezium are equal, if anybody has not written this, they can take the screenshot. You can write after that. But I am saying today, be a little quick in writing. Okay, now question 8. If non-parallel sides of trapezium are equal, prove that it is cyclic. Non-parallel sides of the trapezium are equal. Okay, so making a circle. No need to make a circle because you have to prove that it is cyclic. It is not a cyclic. So let us make a trapezium shape figure. So A, B, C, D is a trapezium where AB and DC will be parallel to each other. Okay, and these sides are equal. So write given. Write AB, CD is trapezium. ABCD is trapezium. Okay, in which AB is parallel to DC, and after that non-parallel sides are equal, it means AD and BC are equal to each other. Then write to prove. And to prove, just write ABCD is cyclic. This we have to prove. Then construction. Let M and N be the perpendiculars. Draw AM perpendicular to DC and BN perpendicular to DC. Proof. Just take these two triangles and prove congruent. In triangle ADM and triangle BCN, in triangle ADM and BCN, let it be angle 1 and 2. So angle 1 is equal to angle 2. Each 90 degree. Then AD is equal to BC. Given. And AM is equal to BN. Anyone who can give me this reason why AM and BM are equal? Why AM and BN are equal? Anyone? How we can say that AM and BN are equal? They are, it is not given in the question. What reason we should write here? Dakshvi, no. Why AM and BN are equal? Koshima is saying perpendicular on parallel lines. Don't say on parallel lines, say between the parallel lines. Okay, now see this. This is a perpendicular. This is also perpendicular. And these are between the parallel lines. So it is a perpendicular distance of parallel line. So in between the same parallel lines, if you are making perpendiculars, then they will also be, means the distance will be equal to each other. Yeah. So this is representing the distance between the parallel lines. Whether you check distance from here or check distance from here or from here, the distance between the parallel lines will be same. And the condition is this should be perpendicular. If you are measuring distance, so it is correct. Perpendicular distance between parallel lines. Okay, that's why this distance will be equal to each other. So triangle ADM is congruent to triangle BCN by which criteria? Right angle, hypotenuse, and side, RHS. So by CBCD, we can say that angle D and angle C are equal by CBCD. Now we can prove the next part of this question. Once D and C are equal, we can say that angle A plus angle D makes 180 degree because of co-interior angle. And co-interior is possible only in case of parallel lines. Yes, AB and DC are parallel. So we can say that A and D will make 180 co-interior. Angles. as we know that, let it be equation one, this CPCD, let this be equation one here. Now in place of D, just write C and write from first. Now, if opposite angles make sum of 180 degrees, see A and C are opposite angles and they are making sum of 180 degree, just write since one pair of opposite angles makes sum of 180 degree, therefore ABCD is cyclic. Note it down, be quick. Moving on to the next question. Question number 9. After every question, I'll wait for just 30 seconds. Practice these questions in practice notebook. Everything will be clear in at one time only. Okay, moving on to question number 9. The easiest question in the exercise or in the chapter. Just the figure is very clumsy. Look here, you need to just look figure in this way, the way I am just trying to explain you. Two circles intersect at B and C. So first of all, just see these two circles are intersecting at B and C. Clear? Okay. Then through B, line segment ABD is drawn. See this, from B point, ABD line is drawn, and from B point, BPQ line is drawn. After that, all these points are joined with C. A is also joined with C, B is also joined with C, D is also joined with C, and Q is also joined with C. This way they have made the figure. First of all, they have drawn these lines. Then they have joined all the points with C. Figure is drawn. Okay, that's it. Prove that ACP and QCD are equal. This ACP and this QCD are equal to each other. How these two angles link to each other? Let this be angle 1, this be angle 2, this be angle 3, and this as angle 4. Write it down. Write in given. Two circles intersects at Koshima, you can rejoin if screen is not visible. Two circles intersect at B and C. To prove angle ACP is equal to angle QCD, which is angle ACP we have let here 1 and 2. So angle 1 we have to prove equals to angle 2. Proof starts from here. Now see this arc AP. Consider this arc AP. And this arc is making two angles. See this, one this on the circle and one this on the circle. Can we say that angle 3 and angle 1 are equal because these angles are made on the circle? So angles subtended by arc AP. If you don't want to write like this, no, arc AP, then you can write in this way also. See, If you are not writing arc AP this way, then you can write in short this way, AP and a sine of arc here. It means arc AP. Angle subtended by arc AP means angle 1 and angle 3 will be equal to each other. Angles in same segment. Now, similarly, look from this side, DQ is also making one angle this, angle 4, and one angle here, angle 2. It means 2 and 4 are also equal. Let this first be equation 1. Now let us write the second. Similarly, angle 2 is equal to angle 4. Second equation. Moreover, you can write here the same reason. Or if you have written similarly, it will work. That's it. After this, you can write one more thing, that angle 3 and angle 4 are equal vertical opposite angles. See this? 3 and 4 are equal vertical opposite angles. Fine, because it is x here. So 3 and 4 are equal to each other. Writing here also, angle 3 is equal to angle 4. Let it be equation 3. And reason being vertically opposite angles. So from first, second, third. See this. 3 is equal to 4 in the third equation. In the third equation, 3 and 4 are equal. That's why 1 and 2 will also be equal. Hence proved. Note it down. Be quick. Moving on to next. 3 more questions are left. Now, next question. If circles are drawn taking two sides of a triangle as diameters, okay, making a triangle. Try to see what I am making here. Just wait. In the same way, we have to make one more. You have to make figure something like this. There is one circle and the other circle. And one circle is made on one side of the triangle as diameter. See this? ABC is a triangle. Where AB is the diameter of this circle and AC is the diameter of this circle. So here AB and AC. Our diameters of two circles, AB and AC, are diameters of two circles. Dennis is again and again asking for the last question. See Dennis once, be quick. Next now. So A and B are the AB and AC are the diameters of two circles, and to prove what we need to prove here, that point of intersection of these circles lie on the third side. See, one point of intersection is here, A. And the other point of intersection, this, it should lie on this side only. Means let this point of intersection be D. So prove D lie on third side. Means D lie on BC. This we have to prove. Right, construction. In construction, join AD. That's it. Okay, after joining AD, starting with the proving part. Since AB is the diameter, so ADB is angle in semicircle. Since AB is diameter, so therefore angle ADB is 90 degree angle in semicircle. Angle in a semicircle. You know that angle in semicircle makes 90 degrees. So this is 90. Okay, similarly, angle ADC is also 90. This is also 90 because this is also angle in a semicircle. So, okay, let us add both. So after adding angle ADB plus angle ADC is equal to 90 plus 90. So angle ADB plus angle ADC makes 180 degree. Means these two angles makes 180 degree, and which is only possible if they are linear pair. It means angle ADB and angle ADC are linear pair or you can write here make it linear pair okay it means ADB and ADC make linear pair and linear pair falls on a straight line so therefore we can say that BDC is a straight line. If BDC is a straight line, we can say that D lies on BC. Hence proved. Note it down. So this is done. Moving on to the next, an easy question. Okay, so Koshima is asking sir to repeat the question. Others also just listen it. AB and AC are the diameters. AB is the diameter of this circle, and AB is the side of this triangle also. And AC is the diameter of this circle. AC is the diameter of this circle, and AC is the other side of the triangle. And BC is the third side of the triangle. As in the question, it was written that circles are drawn taking two sides of the triangle as diameters. We have to draw two circles on two sides of triangles as diameters. So this is one side and this is the other side of the triangle, and both the sides we have taken as diameters. Okay, then we have drawn the circle. After making circle, they are saying that the second point of intersection, this point of intersection, should lie on the third side. Okay, there is one point of intersection here, A. This is the point of intersection of this circle and this circle. And one more point of intersection we have here, D. This point of intersection should lie on BC. Okay, so to prove this, let us join AD. Now, ADB is 90 angle in semicircle. This is a semicircle here. So an angle in a semicircle makes 90 degree. Therefore, ADB is 90. In the same way, we have another semicircle, and we can say that ADC is also a 90. Add both ADB and ADC will make 180 degree. If they both are making 180, it means it is a linear pair. If they are a linear pair, it means linear pair falls on a straight line. Therefore, BDC is a straight line. If BDC is a straight line, it means D lies on BC. That's it. Clear. ABC and ADC are two right triangles with common hypotenuse AC. Okay, I am making first of all a common hypotenuse AC. So this is AC, a common hypotenuse. Now let us draw two right triangles on this. One is ABC. So one is this triangle ABC and one is this triangle ADC. This is also a right angle triangle and this is also a right angle triangle. Just write and given triangle ABC and triangle ADC. Are right triangles. To prove, angle CAD equals to angle CBD. Now from where this comes, CAD and CBD. So CAD is clearly visible, but for CBD we have to draw a line. This is CBD. We have to prove that this angle and this angle are same. It is very clear and it is proved. See this. As we know that angle B is 90 given. And also angle D is 90. This is also given. Right angle triangle. Add both. Angle B plus angle D. Angle B plus angle D is equal to 90 plus 90 is equal to 180 degree. If opposite angles make sum of 180 degree, it means it is cyclic. Okay, if it is a cyclic, then let me draw for you to explain you this circle. Why I have made this circle? Because I have proved it that this ABCD is cyclic. Look here. B, opposite angles make sum of 180 degree. This we have proved here. So it means it is cyclic. So write, since one pair of opposite angles makes 180 degree, therefore A B C D is cyclic. If A B C D is cyclic, then we can say that this angle and this angle are equal. Why? Angles on same segment. See this? This is an arc which is making this angle and this angle. So this and this will be equal to each other, angles in same segment. So therefore, we can say that therefore angle CAD will be equal to angle CBD, angles in same segment. In notebook also you can make cyclic. It's okay. Draw with the other color so that you should remember it, that you have drawn it after proving angles in same segment. Hence proved. Done. And see what is left now. The last question is left. And one more means examples also we need to do from this exercise. And one example is important. The last one that we'll do now, that on Monday, as today is Friday. Now we'll meet on Monday. So on Monday, we'll finish this chapter. Then we'll begin with the next Heron's formula. Okay. Bye. Lecture is over. You can note it down, whosoever has not written.